You can see that we can combine all the elements which includes n and the constants to the other side, and we can write like an plus some b, where this a and b are some combinations of c's, the cost. So we can find that the running time is linear to the input size. This is when the input is already sorted, the best case. What happens if the input is sorted in the reverse order, that is in the descending order? It means that whenever I take out a key, okay, I have to move it to the left end of the far left end of the array. That means that every time, every key has to be compared with every other elements in the array. So in this case, Tj will be equal to j. I have to move till the far end of the array. So Tj will be equal to j for all j that runs from 2 to n. So we have the summation from j running from 2 to n with j. So this we can expand like 2 plus 3 plus 4 up to n. So this we can use the formulae which sums from 1 to n. If I have first n natural numbers, the summation of first n natural numbers will be n into n plus 1 divided by 2. Since we do not have the 1, the series now starts with 2. So we just subtract 1 from n into n plus 1 divided by 2. And the summation which runs from j equal to 2 to n, j minus 1 will be every time it is 1 less than the previous sum. So this sum is actually like 1 plus 2 plus 3 etc. up to n minus 1. So we have n minus 1 into n divided by 2. So when we substitute this into t of 1, which is on the top, the terms with C4, C5 and C6 are going to generate terms which are quadratic in nature, that is we have n squared in them. So when we simplify all these things, we can have some a n squared time. Tn is actually equal to a times n squared plus b times some n and plus c, a constant, a quadratic equation in terms of the input size, which is n. So if we have n elements, okay, the time that we require will be in quadratic. Although we have some linear term and a constant in this quadratic equation, it is not necessary to include them in the time complexity, because the quadratic term, the n squared term, is going to grow much faster compared to the linear term n, which we call as rate of growth of a function. So we can say that the time complexity of the insertion sort is order of n squared, which is quadratic in nature. So why do we do sorting at all? So sorting is useful in many situations. Moreover, we don't have the data just scattered around. We need them to be arranged in a proper way. Okay, the much better way is to have them sorted. We have a searching algorithm called a binary search, which takes sorted input as sorted array as input, where we improve the searching time. We have quite large amount of data nowadays throughout the world, and every time when we wanted to get the data which is relevant for our situation, we need to search. Okay, searching we cannot eliminate in our day-to-day life. Say for example, I have a passport and I wanted to change my address in it. So if I give my passport number as the key, I have I should be able to go and locate the place where I can find the other details of my passport, and then I can change my address. And passport everybody holds. There is billions of records in it, and we have to search in that. Okay, so always the searching time has to be better. So if we have arranged the data in a sorted order, okay, it is easy for us to go and pick the data from where we want. So that's all for now. Thank you so much.